This is into the fire.
I'm really excited to welcome to Into the Fire the gun midfielder, Swans Academy player, and future star of the AFL, Errol Golden. Nice to meet you, Errol.
Thank you very much for having me. Appreciate it.
Pleasure. Now, Errol, you were touted as a future champ a long time back and have been working with the Swans since under-11s. That's just crazy. How did that come about and what sort of opportunities has it given you?
Well, like a lot of boys and girls now that are in the Swans Academy, I just went to the trials. So they have open trials a couple of times every year. And I went down when I was about 9 or 10 and trialed, and I was lucky enough to be selected into the academy. When I was that young, and I've been in it since that day. And it's given me a lot of opportunities to play footy and meet a lot of new people and make a lot of good friends, and help me develop as a footballer. So very grateful to the Swans Academy, and I wouldn't be where I am without them. So yeah,
sounds like a pretty big honor. Now, in my eyes, you run all day. A marathon runner on the field with hands so fast, you'd make a great pickpocket. Add to that a beautiful kick. I know you were good, but just how good a junior were you?
Oh, I don't know if you're asking the right person. I don't really like to, talk about things like that. I always just played footy because I enjoyed it. And obviously when I got awards in my junior footy and was picked in teams, it was always good recognition and I enjoyed it. But I'm not really sure. I think you'll have to ask other people to answer that question for you.
Okay. Now, you're only 172 centimetres, which would be an issue if you weren't so damn good. You've played in midfield all wing your whole life. How will you go if you have to play a small forward role early in your career? Because you aren't bad at hitting the scoreboard, are you?
Well, I don't know about that. I've grown a little bit since then. I think that was my under-16s measurement. So I've luckily grown a little bit since then. But I don't think I have an issue playing as a small forward. I'd be happy to play anywhere on the field. And at AFL level, I think it would be, as I said, I'd be happy to play anywhere. But I've played a lot of midfield, but I've also played a lot of small forward and even played a bit down back. So I'd be happy to play anywhere.
Yeah, it would be good playing anywhere if you were in the AFL.
Exactly right.
Yeah. Now, you started in the NAB League last year and impressed in the championships as a bottom ager. How was the champs and what was it like going head-to-head with the players like Matt Rowe, Noel Anderson and Caleb Sarong, just to name a few?
Oh, it was an awesome experience. As you said, I was a bottom ager, so I was just there to kind of, gain a little bit of experience. And, it was so much fun and got to play alongside of some players that, are on lists and doing pretty well, like Tom Green and Connor Butterick, which was, an awesome experience for someone like myself who was, younger at that time. And, I loved every second of it. And, was just trying to take it all in. And, at that time I was obviously thinking that I'd be able to do it all again this year, but obviously that didn't eventuate. But it was a great experience and I'm very grateful that I got to do it last year.
Yeah, it sounds like an amazing experience. You played a game against Pennant Hills early in the year and faced your great mate and great guy, Brady Campbell. You were best on ground. Thought I'd throw that in there. What was it like to go against him? And did you remind him of your performance and win?
There was maybe a few little subtle digs that I made at Braden after that game, but it was great fun. We started off playing football against each other, and we only started playing with each other probably 3 or 4 years ago, but for years before that we would play against each other. But Braden's one of my best mates, and I'm much rather playing with him than against him. And he had a pretty good game that day as well. And it was a bit of a weird experience. And I don't know. I think we both went a little bit harder at each other, as you tend to do with your best mates. But more importantly, we got the win, as you said, which was the highlight for me. And I let him know about that.
Yeah, Braden's a legend.
He is.
Now, let's look a little at your unbelievable footy attributes. You're an outside midfielder with so much speed and agility. You're so hard to catch. Your vision is only second to Superman. And you accumulate so much ball, the stats man gets cramped from recording your possession. What other traits make you the player you are?
Not really sure. I think the reason that you've mentioned a few of those traits. I think it all comes down to how I read the game, and I think I've got a pretty good footy brain, and you know, that comes off, you know, a little bit of talent, but I think I do a lot of work away from the game, and I watch a lot of vision on my computer, and I annoy a lot of my coaches because of how much feedback I ask for them, and I like to sit down with them after every game and review every single touch I had. So yeah, I think reading the game is probably my biggest strength, and that helps me to you know, get a little bit of the footy when I play, but a lot of hard work goes into that. It's not just something that you can kind of learn overnight. And played footy since I was about 3 or 4 years old, and I've just kind of tried to learn every day when I train and play and get better.
Now, this year was crueled by COVID. What were you looking to improve on this year when the lockdown stopped everything? And what have you done to make sure you're prepared for an AFL gig?
Well, yeah, it was it wasn't great, was it? I was lucky enough here in Sydney and that we did get to play a bit of footy, which was good. I think I got about 15 games out this year, which was a lot more than what I thought I would when we went into lockdown. I wasn't sure if we'd be able to play, but I think I was just looking to improve my skills over the break. I think that's the fastest thing that you can lose touch of, is you can maintain fitness, but if you don't have a kick for a couple of weeks, your skills can go down the drain pretty quick. So I just tried to make sure I always had a footy in my hand and was always going for a kick. So I tried to work on my skills. I was very lucky being in the Swans Academy. They sent us a program for us to do over the break, and I just made sure I followed that program like a Bible, and it held me in good stead for when we did return to footy.
Yeah. So you got to train with the Swans. What was it like training with the Sydney Swans? Did you sneak down and grab a pair of Buddy's boots?
I didn't. I think his foot would probably be twice the size of mine, so that wouldn't work. But no, it was an unbelievable experience. I've done it on a couple of occasions now, so I'm slowly getting less and less nervous the night before. But the first time I did, I was really excited, but also very nervous. But they welcomed me in very quickly and made me feel welcome and comfortable. So it was a very exciting experience for me. And,
it sounded like it was pretty exciting.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Now, you played in the Futures game on the MCG. I bet that was a real experience. What did you take out of that opportunity?
I think it was just, I just enjoyed myself more than anything. Obviously, it was awesome to see one of my best mates get best on ground as well. I think that was, I was so happy for Braden, and it was one of my favorite footy memories seeing him, play so well on the big stage, because I know, how much hard work he puts in, and, I was happy with how I played that day as well. So I think it was just an experience to take in and, have a lot of fun from. It wasn't too serious. It was a good day to showcase our talents, and yeah, it was a very enjoyable day.
Yeah, sounds like it. Okay, let's play a little game of you or Braden Campbell. A selfie goes on Instagram. Who most likely posted it?
I'd say probably me. I'm a bit better on the social media than Braden. He's still learning a little bit.
Yeah, he is. Who's most likely to have a weird isolation haircut?
Oh, that's me as well. I a little bit of dye found its way into my hair over the isolation period. So, and I had a couple of questionable haircuts going on then. And he's always a straighty 180 with his hair. He doesn't like to change it too much. So I'll say me again there.
Okay. Who would be most likely to ask Buddy Franklin for an autograph after training?
That one have to be Braden, I think. Yeah, he's a big, he goes to Collingwood actually, but that sounds like something he would do.
Yeah, it does sound like something he would do. Who is most likely next year to say, I play AFL?
Oh, I'd say Braden again. I think he would. Maybe if he's lining up for some food or something like that, he might just chuck it out there, I reckon.
Who would be the worst to room with? I heard you were both messy.
Yeah, well, lucky enough, we room with each other. So every time we've gone away over the past couple of years, we've always been in the same room. So, we're not great. Our hotel room can turn pretty messy pretty quickly. But He's not too bad to room with. I think we'd both be okay. I think we're pretty normal. I think most boys our age, I can't imagine two that would have too many that would have spotless hotel rooms on a trip away. So
yeah, not a bad answer. Who is the most romantic? Brayden thinks him, by the way.
Thinks me or thinks him?
Thinks himself.
Oh yeah, no, I'd agree with him. He's a big ladies man, Brayden. He yeah, I'd say him. I'd say him by a mile.
Okay, so some true or false questions. You think yourself quite the singer. Is that true?
Yeah, that's very true. Especially when I'm in the shower, I like to have my music playing pretty loud and I'll have a little sing-along, so that's true, yeah.
You have dabbled with the thought of starting your own cooking channel.
I'll say false, but now that you've put the idea in my head, I'll have to have a think about that one.
Maybe. If you weren't a footballer, you'd be a hairdresser.
Oh, I think that's false. I think if I wasn't a footballer, I'd probably be being a soccer player. So, say false.
You and Brayden carry photos of each other in your wallets.
Oh, that's a good one. That's good. Yeah, that's true. We both do. Yeah, true.
Nice. Okay, Errol, you have a massive future. And the fact that the Swans will take you makes me even more excited. I love that club. But the thing for me is, that is super exciting, the fact that you'll play a bit up forward early in your career. Your ability to kick goals is amazing, and that's what the game is about. I love goals, and that's what you provide. You kicking a goal in your first AFL game is a given. So what worries me is that you won't have a celebration fitting for the great man and his talents. Don't worry, mate. I have you covered. Use mine. The end of the fire.
Yeah, I'll definitely use that one. Yeah, good idea.
Yeah, you really need to pull that one out. We'll go with your hair.
I will. No worries.
Well, Errol, I can't thank you enough for giving me some time in your busy schedule. You're a great guy and have a super future. Can't wait to see you on the AFL stage.
Too easy. Thanks so much for having me. It was good fun.
Thanks so much, Errol.
Oh, good. Have a good